Aloha, and welcome to another episode of Debunking the World. Could it be that large food companies are trying to take away part of our freedom? If you want to find out, stick around. What I am about to tell you could affect us all. There's more to this message than first meets the eye. A good cheeseburger. Who would refuse one? Juicy, tasty, and obviously bad for you. Still, people keep running back to companies like McDonald's and Burger King, even though over 40% of Americans are overweight, and even 18.5% or 13.7 million children in America are overweight. Obesity is one of the leading causes for many deaths and illnesses in the US. In the mid-2000s, people stumbled on what is referred to as the cheeseburger bill. But what the heck is that? It almost sounds like there could be a restriction on fast food coming. But that's not quite it. Woohoo! Tobacco companies have been sued for giving people lung cancer. Oil companies have been sued for polluting the environment. And, of course, fast food restaurants have been made responsible for making people fat. One example is a lawsuit filed in 2002. Two Bronx teenagers accused McDonald's of making them fat by serving them highly processed food that affected their health. Obviously, the fast food companies don't want to be sued for this or other claims like being responsible for people's diabetes. The Cheeseburger Bill, or officially called Personal Responsibility in Food Consumption Act, is supposed to prevent all incidents like these. The official statement says, to prevent legislative and regulatory functions from being usurped by civil liability actions brought or continued against food manufacturers, marketers, distributors, advertisers, sellers, and trade associations for claims of injury relating to a person's weight gain, obesity, or any health conditions associated with weight gain or obesity. Now, what does this mean using English? The so-called Personal Responsibility in Food Consumption Act is supposed to keep people from suing food companies for reasons like being overweight. If you eat fast food, you're supposed to know it's bad for your health, and you alone are responsible for eating at restaurants like McDonald's. Note that the act is not about making people fail with their lawsuits against food companies. It wants to prevent even the attempt of such lawsuits against food companies. This does not apply in cases where mislabeled, misadvertised, or otherwise deceptively sold products contribute to a plaintiff's obesity problem. So basically, if you buy fast food and every transaction was completely legal, you cannot make food companies responsible for your health issues. To quote James Sensenbrenner, as one judge put it, if a person knows or should know that eating copious orders of supersized McDonald's products is unhealthy and could result in weight gain, it is not the place of the law to protect them from their own excesses. At first, this doesn't sound so bad, especially acknowledging that at the time of debates on this act, not a single obese plaintiff had successfully sued the food industry. Each case was found in favor of the industry. Most people would agree, having each individual hold responsibility for their eating behaviors is how it's supposed to be. But the cheeseburger bill is more than it seems at first glance. To quote Medium.com, outlawing an entire strain of lawsuit isn't something to be taken lightly, and it certainly should not be done in the name of minor economic benefit. In general, Congress could outlaw many types of suits and save heaps of money for businesses and taxpayers on litigation. But the checking power of the judicial branch would be severely limited. Representative Pete Stark says, many of the pending cases are for false advertising, claiming food is low fat when it's really not. And this bill is so broadly worded that it would preclude such cases from going forward. The threat of legitimate lawsuits against fast food corporations is as much a part of creating social change as is the threat of a congressional investigation. Even more important than the issue of obesity or congressional meddling in the judicial branch is the fundamental right of every American to have their day in court. Congress has no business preemptively closing the courthouse doors to a particular group of Americans. Basically, it is possible the bill is vague enough to block lawsuits accusing the industry of false advertising, for example, making it impossible to sue these companies, even though you have a legitimate reason for it. Simply the threat of suits is enough to ensure the industry maintains fair behavior, but there is far more to it than meets the eye. Michelle Simon, a lawyer and food policy expert, argues in her book Appetite for Profit, what scares food companies even more than costly jury verdicts is the prospect of the discovery process, when lawyers are allowed access to the defendant's documents and other inside information, unearthing damning information about dishonest industry practices. This, in turn, can open the door to a plethora of new government regulations. Here Simon is arguing that food companies might be hiding unlawful behavior in regulations written down in documents. Should the cheeseburger bill become law, it would greatly reduce the chance of such documents to be found. She gives a great example in her book. An avalanche of damning documents discovered through litigation against the tobacco industry revealed so much information that an entire research group at the University of California is currently dedicated to its study. The food industry has learned from tobacco that litigation is a powerful public interest tool. She goes on to say, "What exactly will be revealed through litigation that would harm Big Food? One possibility is evidence of efforts to addict consumers to its products. According to information uncovered by the Physicians Committee for Responsible Medicine, some food manufacturers deliberately target consumers who are vulnerable to certain food addictions. Recent studies reveal that some unhealthy foods, such as chocolate, sugar, meat, and cheese, are physically addictive. Overeaters also demonstrate typical addiction behaviors such as craving, loss of control, and relapse. Lawsuits could help uncover the extent to which the food industry has known about, concealed, and taken advantage of such food addictions." Now, we all know fast food has addicting attributes. But what if Big Food is actively making its consumers addicted to their products? Right now, we can sue these companies for many reasons, and in time, there might be evidence found for such claims. Should the cheeseburger law ever be enforced, it would make our chances of finding such evidence almost non-existent. Food companies could actively break the law without much fear of discovery, because with an entire strain of lawsuit gone, lawyers will have fewer and fewer reasons to look into the actions of these companies. Gladly, until now, the act never became a law, but although the bill failed federally, about half of the states in the US have passed some version of the bill. If you ever hear of this in the future, make your voices be heard. We cannot allow big companies to be able to act without really having the chance to check them. For my end statement, I will again quote Medium.com. "As a student in nutrition, I have witnessed firsthand the feeble grasp that most of the public has on nutritional science. Many Americans are confused and often mistrust advice, even qualified advice, because of their confusion. Is this their own fault? Is America's nutritional illiteracy a result of our people being too lazy to read up on the topic? Or is it because there is a powerful industry of diet products and junk food manufacturers purposely obscuring prudent, qualified nutritional guidance in an effort to promote the consumption of their own products? Noting the conflicting phenomenon of our diet-obsessed society that is simultaneously one of the most obese nations on earth, I posit the latter. Now, what do you think? Are people responsible for what and how much they eat? Should companies be held responsible for offering unhealthy food? Should an entire strain of lawsuit be outlawed and give big food companies the ability to act without really being checked? Leave me a comment and be sure to check back in the future. Some interesting videos on food companies like McDonald's and food in general are bound to come. Until then, God bless.